back again. This is a little video that I'm going to do now. I had some interest shown in the tool post setup that I have on my Taig Lathe, and they asked me if I could explain or give a broken down view of the parts and how it fits. Until recently, the only lathe that I had was a Drummond M type 1947 3.5 inch lathe, English lathe, and I had it for probably 40 years, and at one point when I was still in England, I was over here in Canada, I decided that I wanted to put a quick change tool post on the machine, and I'm going to hold this leaflet up. I have no interest whatsoever in this company. In fact, I don't even know if they still exist now. But I purchased this design. I thought it was quite good, and fortunately, it did turn out very good. So when I sold the Drummond, of course that set went with the machine. So I decided that with the Taig lathe that I would try and make something similar, but in a smaller scale. So I had the dimensions of the unit from this literature, and so I drew it up on CAD full size, and then I scaled it all down to half scale, and started from there. Now it's very simple. It's basically very simple unit. It consists of a T-nut, a T-screw, T-bolt, and what I did was I modified it slightly, made it thinner there, down at the base, and found that it fitted nicely this way, and it was a larger bolt size, and I brought this over just to give you a demonstration. This is the top slide on the lathe, although it's the same as the cross slide. So the bolt slides in the T-slots like that, and if you look at it closely, you'll see that it's quite a nice fit. It's a bit loose, but it's really quite a nice fit, so it gives lots of strength in the T-slot area. So that was my first thing that I did, was to modify this high tensile T-bolt, and got that finished. So the rest of the unit consists of just a round plug or spacer, and I machined, I think it was 48 serrations. Just did it on the mill, and put those serrations in there, And I believe this is a tool steel. It's a drill rod, I think, or something like that. But I never hardened it. And I figure that if you're careful when you use the unit in changing the different holders, that it'll last for a long, long time without toughening it up. So anyway, that drops down on there, and there's a recess in there, and then all I made was a piece of rod with a hole to drop down over the bolt, and it drops down into the recess, and then I just made a nut that goes on top. Come on, there you go. So that's a nut that goes on top, and I made a key, nice square key, just for tightening. So that's basically the unit. I then got some hot rolled 1-inch by 1-inch hot rolled steel, mild steel, and at that time I had an Atlas 7-inch shaper, and so I cut off the sections. I made 8 of them, and machined them all 4 sides and the ends in the shaper. Now the shaper gives a really nice finish. So what I did after making them or finishing them on the shaper, I then went over to the belt sander and just placed it up against the belt sander and just kind of polished it up all the way around. And you'll see that this is the parting off tool, and it works very well, holds the tool bit nicely and snug and solid, and it's just basically a block with a hole in it, and it's split down through the center at one end. And there's a locking screw on this face. So now, when you have it on the lathe, and the lathe is with the handles there facing you, this just drops down, and you have your adjustment for height there. And that's basically just a ordinary cap screw. And I just machined a 45, or maybe it was a bit less than that, on the tip, and that drops down and locates in the serrations, and I believe each serration will give you 7.5 degrees move around. And although you look down at the tool, it's very easy to locate the serration that you were in previously when you were changing over. There really is no difficulty in it at all, so it works pretty good. Let's see, what else can I say about that? A lot of people think that there's too much overhang, and it's on this little pillar. This pillar is, I think it's 1/2 inch, is it? Yeah, it's 1/2 inch. So it's located on a 1/2 inch tubing, and So it goes pretty good. There's another tool for it. So I've got 8 different kinds of tools. I've got just ordinary ones that are like an ordinary holder. And then I find that these ones that have an angle on them are really nice, because they keep the back end of the holder away from the job. So that's that works very good. Made in China. There you go. I'm one of those people that use Chinese stuff. But that tool bit, I can hand that down to my nephew. When I die, I could hand that down and he could use it. So for about $10, you got a tool that will last you a lifetime. There's all you need to do is to just figure out how to grind a tool bit, and there you go. So it's Chinese, but I've used it a lot, and I don't have to grind it very often, resharpen. Here's another one. Left hand. Yeah, this is a left hand tool holder. You can actually use it in both ways. You can have it around that way and have your tool bit sticking out here. There's not much point to it, I guess, and again, it would still be a left hand in a sense. So all of these, it didn't take very long to build. There's not an awful lot to it. Most of the work is in making these holders. Let's see, I've got a holder here that I thought I would incorporate something into it. Let's go and get my holder. There you go. There we go. So I have one of these units for holding a dial indicator, and so what I did was I made this block. I made this block here, and you'll notice that just there's a set screw, and underneath that set screw is a little spring, and on the other side of that spring, coming into this hole here, there's a little ball bearing. So what I did was, the idea was that I can place this in there and press it down, and now it's nice and snug, but I can move it this way or I can move it that way, up and down, all over the place. So, and it saves me having to get a set screw, a Allen key, and lock something up. And it's good enough to allow you to use a dial indicator on there. So again, it's got two purposes really, this particular one. So I don't know what more I can say about that. The screws, the locking screws, are square headed, and I made up a tool for that. This incorporates, to get the square, I made two parts, like a letter L, and machine them together in the outside diameter to fit inside the holder of the key. So that's how I did the squares in both, in that one as well. That square is made up of two parts. It's like the old way of making dies years ago, before they had EDM. Used to make dies of different shaped apertures, and it would be like a jigsaw puzzle, and it would drop down into a section of the die of the shoe, and that's how you built your dies up. So that's how I made the square for the key. The screws are 3/16. I guess they're a 3/16 would be what, 10/24, I think so. Here's a holder that I had to make when I was doing the radiator and machining the fins. I bought another parting off tool and made up this adapter to hold them in one of my holders. There, you can see. So, and they're all, the height is all adjustable. It's very simple. I would like to have got screws with nylon inserts in them so that they were a little bit tighter. But I just used ordinary screws, and that's all I could get at the time. And I've never bothered to change them, because there's nothing wrong. They work perfectly. So that's about it. It's really quite a nice, simple design of a quick change tool post. It's a bit different from the type that you normally see. But it works okay, it works fine, it machines fine. So that's basically that. The only other thing I can comment on is that I've got these two units here. I made these up. I noticed that on one of the videos that I was watching, the machinist, he had a little tin like this, a tin container with a chimney on the top kind of thing. And I thought, wow, that's a good idea. Keeps the swarf out. I find that if I use an open container, it gets filled up with bits of chips and God knows what else. So I thought, I'll make something up. So if that gives anybody an idea, it's pretty simple. So that's just Dorin, and it's just inside, and makes a nice little container for cutting oil. So there you go. Okay, I can't think of anything else to say. I know that the viewer particularly wanted to see how I made these, and basically it was just one by one hot rolled steel that I machined. Just took a skim off in the shaper on all six sides, and then buffed up on the 1-inch belt sander. And this was done in this serration, 48 serrations. That was done in the lathe in the mill, with a setup of a rotary table, a dividing head, and putting them at angles so that the end mill corner gave a nice channel. Of course, they can't be very deep because it's a small area. So that, in fact, it's Yeah, 1.224. So it's just a basic outside diameter with 48 serrations in there. And that's about it. I don't use, I've got one carbide boring tool that that I use, but I don't normally use carbide. I just stick with HSS. It kind of suits me, and it's easy to shape and for particular jobs. So that's that. And of course, this unit here is my modified top slide, which you'll see if you look at any of the videos that I've done. I've got several videos that show that being used. So anyway, I'll call off now and check this video. I sometimes wonder whether I should bother. I'm not really all that good at it, but anyway, if somebody gets enjoyment out of it, that's good. Okay, thanks very much.